If you're looking to build your God Squad, head over to CheapMaddenCoins.com for the cheapest prices, instant delivery, and 24-hour customer support. Hit the link in the description and use code WOLF for 10% off. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's King Wolf. Welcome to today's video. In today's video, we're going to go over the gun bunch from the Atlanta Falcons playbook. Now, I'm going to break this one down slowly so you guys can understand it. We're going to go coverage by coverage in our videos. Today, we're going to talk about man defense because I feel like that's the most important one that you guys want to know about because you're struggling with it. And you can beat it really easy from the Atlanta Falcons playbook if you know what you're doing and know what you're looking for, okay? Before we get into today's video, drop a like on this video. Let's try to get this one here to 356,000 likes. I know we can do it, man. Subscribe if you're new for good luck. Don't subscribe if you want bad luck. All right, that's on you. That's not on me. That's on you, bro, okay? All right. Come remember, the Wolfpack link is in the description. Let's talk about the Atlanta Falcons playbook. Now, remember what I told you guys in the previous video. If you didn't see it, route technicians on your wide receiver. All right. Now, the way I'm going to construct my offense for my gun bunch is I'm putting my route technician, which is Amari Cooper, on the left side. So if you play Mutt, you don't have a route technician and you're trying to beat man defense, all I can offer you is my hopes and wishes. Okay. Good luck, my man, because without that, it's going to be very hard. Very hard. You could put slot apprentice. You could put where you can change routes on receivers. None of that matters. If you don't have route technician, none of it matters. All right. I'm trying to get this into your minds. Okay. I have it on my Jerry Rice, but I need a probably a little bit faster wide receiver I can put it on. Put in the comments, man, what other wide receiver I can put that on. Gun bunch, name of the plays, the Atlanta cell. It's very simple. Like I said, route technician on the left, second best wide receiver on the right. Michael Gallup, he's got like 84, 86, a medium, a short route running, something like that. His speed is not as good as Amari or John Johnson, but from the gun bunch, Atlanta Falcons, it's not all about the speed no more. We have to run routes to beat these. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have to run routes. So Atlanta cell, let me show you guys how to run it against cover two man first. Let's go ahead and pick something that's, let's do $326 cover two man blitz. Okay. Now it's simple. I have faith in Cooper on the left side to get open with route technician, just enough for me to throw that route. But the route, I'm not looking for that route. What we're looking for is the B route. Now, if we run the play stock the way it is, just snap the ball, Gallup might get pinned. I don't know, but his corner route, the way he does his C route, it's just too risky right here. So you just don't want to run it. Like, he gets open, but in a real game, he's not going to get open like that, okay? I promise. Trust me. So we need to make a couple changes for this right here. First, we're going to drag A and slant RB, just like that. This is what everybody pretty much does. And the reason you're doing that is because you are creating some man-beating routes, but it's more to just clear the right side of the field out so you can get a one-on-one. So against cover two man, first thing you got to do, the most important tip, and not a lot of people are going to tell you this, when you snap the ball after we do our setups or whatever, you're looking at the safeties, homies. You're not looking at the rest of the players. The great quarterbacks, when they snap the ball, guess who they're looking at first? They're looking at the safeties. They want to know automatically what is the coverage. Now, if he's calling cover two man and you snap the ball and you're looking at those two high safeties and they shoot down, well, guess what? Now, chances are if they put curl flats and they back them up 20, 25 yards, your B route, he's gonna be rendered useless, okay? So then you're going to have to change how you run your plays, and I'm going to show you what I mean. So let's assume we're going to motion them out. We don't know what's going on. We don't know what our opponent's doing. So we're just going to see it. Okay. So we're going to motion out Gallup. And before he can stop, you snap the ball. Now, why are we doing that? We're doing that so the defense can't press him or guard him correctly. There'll always be a step off. Always will be a step off. So for that, we don't need our route technician from the left side on the right side, okay? What we need is our route technician to get a boost on whatever cut he can from a standing position where he's just he's just sitting there. But with our second best wide receiver, we're going to need everything we can to break this man defense. So motion slanting, motion drags. Like I said, I'm going to go over that right now with you guys. But let's start this play the way it is. As I motion Gallup out, I'm going to look at the two high safeties. Snap the ball. They're dropping backwards. Okay, now I know B route over here, right side. Boom. Gets the space I need. Easy money. There's nothing they can do to guard that route because of the motioning. If you let them stop, then they can. Now, I don't know with this guy guarding him, because I don't have it on fastest, set it on fastest. I might want to do that. But if you try to run it while he's planted and then take off to the right, chances are they can catch him. You know what I'm saying? So be careful with letting him plant and do that, because I'm telling you guys right now, it's not a good thing. It's not a good thing. So the setup is going to be RBA slant drag. Okay. And then you can do whatever you want with Y. Okay. You could put him on routes. You could put him on a swing. You can try to get something out of him if you want, or you can block him. So remember, when we snap the ball, we're not looking at the line and linebackers. We're looking at the safeties, homies. Okay. Boom. Just like that. Let them cut. Simple as that. Every single time. All right. Now, the route technician on the left side, pay attention to him as I snap the ball and I look at the safeties. I'm going to look for X. Look at the speed boost he gets when he cuts. This is what route technician does. Boom. That's all I need. Just that little step. And Prescott really can't get the ball there, but you'll see that he's going to be open even in this defense. I felt like it was a good idea to just take our time, go slowly with these plays. So if you want to use them, you'll get the full understanding. You know what I'm saying? So here we go again. Just like that. You'll see that little speed boost he gets because he's the route technician, and you can throw that over the middle. Now, this is where it becomes tricky, because the user can do what he wants. Like, he can sit there and float with that, right? He can float with the X route, and that's going to take your route technician away. So let's assume, okay, now he's guarding X, and he put purples out there. We're noticing that the safeties are dropping down. They're not actually going backwards. So when you snap the ball, look at the twos. I'm just going to snap the ball right now. But watch them back up. You know they're in blues, okay? So that's, see right there how close he is? I didn't motion him, so they get more. And better backs, corner safeties, whoever's on him, are going to really press him. So you're going to have to motion that guy out and don't let him plant and then snap the ball. And it'll just be good for you. They'll always be a step behind. So let's assume that they are running clouds or purples, right? All you're going to want to do is you'll just change your B route. Okay. You can change your B route and you can like push A out of the way and then put RB on a slant like this and then motion them out. So if they put curls, any type of thing like that, then you just hit this guy. Now, if you want more separation or more yards, this is what I recommend you do. So you're going to motion drag this guy and you're just going to clear everybody out of the way. Okay. You can even send your running back away. Okay. Send them all away. Motion drag this guy. Okay. If it's curl flats. And then when he catches the ball, then it's more yards because you're clearing out the left side of the field, getting this guy ready and open. You know what I mean? And you could do that even if they're backing up with two zones. So if they back up with two zones, you can do that. You can also do this where you motion him across. Don't let him plant. Right? Don't let him plant. He'll always be a step ahead. No matter what. Now, drags, I don't really like drags, bro, like that much in this game. I really don't. I don't like drags. You'll see as I'm trying to get this to get open. You see how my man's like right when I catch the ball. Well, right there, I got some yards, but drags, I don't really look for drags a lot, man. If you look at my gameplays and stuff, I'm not really looking for drags. Okay, so cover one. So that's cover two, man. And cover one, it's going to be the same way that you look at it. Right? You'll be able to tell if they're in cover one by simply just looking at the one safety that takes off. We're going to run the same play, same thing, and we'll do cover one out of dime. I mean, dollar. Cover one robber press. It's going to be the same setup, okay? Now, you can one play TD this if you're smart enough, right? But let's go ahead and assume that we're just testing it and see what's going on, okay? Let's say he's not backing people up and he's putting people like in clouds and stuff, okay? So right here, we got this guy. Now, if we want to throw the one play touchdown, this is what you do. This is why this play is cool. You see the RB route? Did you see how he steps in? That helps us. So what we're going to do is we're going to leave B the way he is. Okay. And then we're going to take A and drag him. And then we're going to motion RB over. And once he gets to the left side, you're going to snap the ball. What this is going to do is if he does run cover one and he has a one high safety, the RB route is going to keep him honest, which means our route technician gets opened up on the left side. Now, you're not always going to have the X route wide open. But with Route Technician, you're giving yourself a better chance for him to be open. Let me show you what I mean. As we come over here, we snap the ball. He's going to take a step inside, go keeps the middle blue honest. We fire this over the right side. And I think that separation was because of Route Technician. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to change the defense coaching adjustments to speed, just to give you guys like a real idea of what you're going to face. So if someone changes it to speed, we come back to the Atlanta cell, we go to coaching adjustments, and we go by speed like this. Okay. And then we come back to cover one at a dollar. If I can find it here somewhere. Oh, I did cover two. Okay. Right here. Bro, why does it keep going back to cover two? You're kidding me. All right, here we go. Same thing. Okay. Drag A. We're going to leave RB the way he is. I'm going to double team the right side because I'm going to be floating to the right. So I want to make sure that I have the protection there. Snap the ball. It takes a step inside. That's what I want. This guy's coming actually for me. I got to throw the ball away. But look at X. Look at X. You see what I'm saying? Look at X. He's still getting that separation even when people match on him by speed. So dragging A. Actually, I'm going to send my running back out on the route. That way it's less pressure. Less pressure. And you'll see B. X cover one, just like that, and it's still Ward on him, so that's different. I guess Ward. Let's check the Chiefs cornerbacks. Let's see who is the fastest one there. That way we could put him on Amari Cooper. So we're gonna see with Route Technician. In some instances, depending on who's on your opponent, who's on your wide receiver, he's gonna get a quick break, but then these guys are gonna catch him because they have more speed, more acceleration. They just overall better stats than who's on him already. So in a real game setting, you're gonna face this problem right here. Okay, you're gonna see it in action where they actually catch up to the wide receiver. So we're gonna motion in gallop over here, and I want you guys to see just how it works, how the guy actually comes in and catches him. So I get the little speed boost, but watch him. You see him catch him? So now if I try to throw that, he's challenged. So you can't always do it. Ratings take over after the ability. So like you get the boost with Route Technician. So if I see that and I see that he's catching him, now start thinking in your head, homies, okay? Think about this. I'm trying to give you guys the idea behind this. Once you see this, okay? Boom. Right, once you see it, this guy's actually coming for me. You see him catching him? Now that we know that's a thing and that's what's gonna happen when you try to run, this is when you start quick firing to him, okay? He can't catch him on the initial boost. So what do we do? What we're gonna do is we're gonna send everybody to the right. Let's go ahead and motion this guy back out. Boom, right here. Can't catch him on the initial. He can only catch him whenever he's running the route longer, okay? So over again, I'm gonna show you guys just how to abuse all these people, man, okay? Send everybody to the right. Motion snap this guy. Here we go again. Can't keep up with him on the initial boost. And I'm gonna just get the yards, bro. Snead is better than Ward. Who would have known? So if you're using the Chiefs online, bro, there you go. Here we go again. Now he's an X factor because now they can't stop him. Initial boost. That's all I need is that little inside boost. And Snead, nobody can do nothing about it. I don't care who it is. They're not going to be able to do nothing about this play right here as you do this. Quick boost. That's all I need. So now you're not looking for the one play TD. What you're doing is you're just attacking real quick. That's how you utilize the Route Technician instantly, okay? Boom. Use it to its strengths, not its weaknesses. Don't wait on those routes. So there it is, man. Hope you guys appreciate the video. Like, comment, subscribe. Love you guys, man. Peace.